listen. No. I've been back there and I cannot got to, but I got to know. Are we still friends? Can we be friends? Are we still friends?
YouTube, what's good y'all, man? Welcome back to the channel. If you haven't already, go hit that subscribe button. We're almost at 800 subscribers. I appreciate all the support on my recent videos. I got another fire video today. I appreciate every last one of you that clicked on this video. We getting better every single day we play this game, you know what I mean? I'm gonna be dropping a 6 video very soon for my 6-6 build. This is the build that I'm on. Make sure you go watch the build video. I dropped that a couple weeks ago. Shooting is really an option on this build. I can really score a 2 almost every time and just dunk the ball. I just get around whoever's guarding me every single time. They can't guard me. I'm unguardable. Listen, you need this build, man. This is the meta build this year. This build can do everything. Being able to shoot as well consistently, no one is going to be able to stop you with this. So go over to your controller settings and turn this on release. Release is very late. I feel like this is the best. I've been using this in 2K23 and now in 2K24. And I'm going to continue to use it as long as 2K has this system where they have 50 different timings. So make sure you have on very late or release. All right, but these are some badges that you're going to want to focus on. Green Machine is a great badge for shooting threes. It gives you an additional boost after you make a few. One of my favorite badges in the whole game is Open Looks. A lot of my shots, most of all my shots are open shots. This badge pops up almost every single time. I have it on gold on this build. If you have like a 90 mid-range, you can get a Hall of Fame. I know some people on the 6-6 builds, they like to go high mid-range and low 3-point. So yeah, this badge is one of the best in the entire game, so make sure you have this as high as possible. Another great badge that's been in the game for this year and last year, Agent 3. Another great badge for pretty much most of your shots that you're going to be taking. Pull-up shots, pretty much any shots that aren't catch and shoot, really. Blinders and Deadeye, obviously those are pretty good badges, but not really important if you're shooting open shots. These badges just come in handy at the last second or when I'm contested, you know what I mean? So, but when you got sharpshooter takeover, you know, the game is pretty much broken. You can shoot from anywhere with a low 3-point rating. So if I was a point guard, I would obviously focus on Agent 3 and open looks and Deadeye, limitless range, stuff like that, you know what I'm saying? But if you're a spot up, all you really need is open looks and catch and shoot. Those are gonna do you pretty good. And then once you get takeover, you know, you shouldn't miss. But if you're a point guard and you want to get this Agent 3, because that's obviously probably the best badge in the entire game for point guards. So I'd mostly focus on that and open looks, getting that as high as possible. When you pop sharp takeover, it boosts your green window in limitless range areas as well. So you don't really need silver limitless range. Bronze is perfectly fine, which you get that at an 85 3-point. So as long as you have sharp takeover, you're going to be able to hit these deep shots without a high limitless range. After I post this video, I'm gonna work on my 6 video, so I got y'all, don't worry. Make sure you have notifications on so you know when I'm posting and when I'm not posting. But yeah, I'm gonna post a breakdown with that too, show you how to, you know, do a little more advanced dribble moves, because I already dropped a basic tutorial. So if you want to go watch that and learn how to do the basic stuff that I did in this video, go ahead and watch that. I don't know if a lot of people know this or if everybody knows this. Your dribble pull-up ties into your fadeaways. So go on over to Dribble Pull-Up and put on Pro 2. This is the smoothest and quickest dribble pull-up slash fade in the entire game. I've tried out every single one, and I believe that Pro 2 is the best one. All you need for this is to be under 6'10", so you can get this on a 6'3", 6'2", you know what I mean? So I use this on both builds that I have. Alright, so this is my favorite jump shot probably for 6'5 and under 6'10 guards. All you need is an 86 midi or an 86 3-point. The lower base is Ben Shepherd. Upper release one is Oscar Robinson. And then for the upper release two, you're going to go James Harden. The blending and release speed, the release speed all the way up to make it the fastest that you can. You'll get an A+ release speed if you do this. And then for the animation blending, you're going to go 80% Oscar Robinson, 20% James Harden. And then you see how the player just flicks the wrist like that? That's when you're going to release the ball if you have your shot timing on release. Basically, after your player flicks it and the ball leaves your hand, that's when you're going to let go of square or the right trigger, whatever you shoot with. For my second jump shot, you're going to need an 88 mid-range or an 88 3-point. This is a little bit slower, but it has a better timing stability. For the lower base, you're going to go Tracy McGrady. Upper release 1, Oscar Robinson again. For upper release 2, you're going to go Evan Fournier. And with the blending and release speed, you're going to go 57 Oscar Robinson and 43% Evan Fournier. Release speed all the way up again, just to make sure this is the fastest jump shot that it can be. Tracy McGrady is my second favorite base for tall guards. It's pretty smooth and it gets high up. It has a good release height. So if you don't like the first one, you can go with this one. This is a good second option. These are for people who went low on their mid-range or 3-point. All you need for this jump shot is an 80 3-point or an 80 mid-range. The lower base is JT Thor. It's a pretty smooth base. Upper release 1, once again, is Oscar Robinson. For the upper release 2 is El Shooter. For blending and release speed, you're going to go 60% Oscar Robinson, 40% El Shooter. Release speed all the way up. To make this the fastest possible, it still gets an A release speed, bro. So this jump shot's gonna be fast for you. If you want to turn it down, you can go ahead and turn it down. If you're a spot up, you don't really need the fastest jump shot if you're a spot up shooter, because you'll have all the time in the corner to pretty much shoot if your point guard's getting you that open. So as long as you could time it, that's the point of, you know, jump shooting, just honestly timing the shot and making the shot. That's all that really matters. And thank you if you watched this whole video through. I greatly appreciate your support. Hope you have a wonderful day, and I'm out. Peace.